Leave down black men and dig. Reach up black men and women and pull all nature's knowledge to you. Turn you around and make a conquest of everything, north and south, east and west. And then when you will have wrought will, you will have merited God's blessings. And as you bow down to the white man today, so will other races bow down to you and call you a race of masters because of the superiority of your minds and your achievements. We must canonize our own saints, create our own martyrs, and elevate the positions of fame and honor. Black men and black women who have made a distinct contribution to our racial history. Sojourner Truth is worthy of a place of sainthood alongside of Joan of Arc. Crispus Attucks and George William Garden are entitled to the halo of martyrdom with no less glory than that of the martyrs of any other race. Africa's produced countless numbers of men and women in war and peace whose luster and bravery outshone that of any other people. Then why not see good and perfection in ourselves? God made man lord of his creation, gave him possession and ownership of the world. And you have been so darned lazy that you have allowed the other fellow to run away with the whole world. And now he's bluffing you and tell you that the world belonged to him and that you have no part in it. I don't have to apologize to anybody for being black, because God Almighty knew exactly what he was doing when he made me black. You race of cowards, you race of imbeciles, you race of good-for-nothings. If you cannot do what other men have done, what other races have done, what other nations have done, then you had better die. Can we do it? We can do it. Is any leadership that teaches you to depend upon another race is a leadership that will enslave you. Let me say that again. Any leadership that teaches you to depend upon another race is a leadership that will enslave you. They gave leadership to our foreparents and that leadership made them slaves. But we decided to find a leadership of our own to make ourselves free men. Babylon did it. Assyria did it. France under Napoleon did it. Germany under Prince von Bismarck did it. Britain under William Pitt, Earl of Chatham did it. America under George Washington did it. Africa with 400 million black people can do it. Because when the history of my suffering is complete, future generations shall have in their hands the guide by which they shall know the sins of the 20th century. I know, and I know you two believe in time, but we shall wait patiently for 200 years if need be to face our enemies to our posterity. After my enemies are satisfied, in life or death I shall come back to serve even as I served before. In life I shall be the same, in death I shall be a terror to the foes of African liberty. Don't need to be the real Marcus Garvey I would like to be. If I may come in an earthquake or a cyclone or a plague or pestilence or as God would have me, then be assured that I shall never desert you and make your enemies triumph over you. If I should die in prison in Atlanta, my work shall not only just begin, but I shall live in the physical or the spiritual to see the day of Africa's glory. When I am dead, wrap the mantle of the red, the black and the green around me. For in the new life I shall rise up with God's grace and blessings to lead the millions up the heights of triumph in the colors that you well know. Look for me in the world when there's a storm. Look for me all around you. For I shall come back and bring with me countless millions of black slaves who have died in America, who have died in the West Indies, and millions who have died in Africa to aid you in the fight for liberty, freedom, and life. The world today has gone drunk and crazy with its power. Such to injustice, fraud, and lies have crushed the unfortunate. But if I'm crushed by the system of influence and misdirected power, my cause shall rise again to plague the conscience of the corrupt. For this I'm happy to suffer and even die. But I will write the history for the millions that are coming and leave the posterity to reckon with the host for the deeds of their fathers. Let's laugh at you. Return the laughter to them. If they mimic you, return the compliment with equal force. They have no more right to dishonor, disrespect, and disregard your feeling in manhood than you have in dealing with them. Honor them when they honor you. Disrespect and disregard them when they vilely treat you. Their arrogance is but skin deep, an assumption that has no foundation in morals or in law.